from a tragic plane crash just off the coast of Grand Bahama to fireworks and drama within the Progressive Liberal Party. We've got these stories and so much more. This is the Tribune's Top 5. Thank you so much for joining us. Kicking off our top five this week is the unexpected deaths of four Americans when the plane they were on plummeted in waters just off of Grand Bahama.
Horrendous was how a recovery crew member described a plane crash in shallow waters just 5 miles northwest of Freeport, Grand Bahama, that killed four senior American timeshare investors on Monday morning. The group were from Aqua Sun Investments, Inc., a Florida timeshare corporation with major investment ties in Freeport. Robert Dean Carlson, vice president of Aqua Sun, was piloting the twin-engine Cessna 340 aircraft. Also on board were managing director and lawyer for the company, R. Michael Kennedy, Terry Haynes, head of the sales and marketing department, and Matt Sokolowski, head of the IT department. Mr. Carlson took off from the Ormond Beach Municipal Airport at around 8:30 a.m., and the aircraft plummeted, officials believe, at around 10 a.m., instantly killing everyone on board. Their bodies were in a gruesome state, an official told the Tribune. Meanwhile, thousands of Bahamas Electricity Corporation employees had the darkness and intense heat to combat after hours of power outages around New Providence on Tuesday. BEC officials blamed a fierce thunderstorm and lightning activity for challenges on their generation network. Several units at BEC's Clifton Pear Power Station failed as a result. Customers complained of having no electricity for 4 hours between 2 a.m. and 6 a.m., and then again between 8 a.m. and 9 a.m. Later the same day, there were disruptions in parts of eastern New Providence. Then on Wednesday, Deputy General Manager of BEC Siobhan Cambridge confirmed that there would be further power cuts as the corporation load sheds. Abaco was also affected. However, their power loss was the result of copper theft at the island's Wilson City Power Station.
After about a year of parliamentarians and political pundits posturing for and lobbying against value-added tax implementation, the Christie administration passed the controversial legislation, but not without opposition.
And the value-added tax bill was passed late Wednesday night by a vote of 22-8. However, Greg Moss, Marco City MP, voted no alongside all seven members of the opposition that were present in the session. Parliamentarians voted after 2 days of at times bitter debate that entailed criticisms from PLP backbenchers. In the lead-up to the vote, East Grand Bahama MP Peter Turnquest said Bahamians would be faced with double taxation when VAT is implemented at a rate of 7.5% on January 1st next year. He called for one system of taxing. Residents should either face border taxes or VAT. The day before, Mr. Moss blasted the Christie administration for sticking to the decision to implement VAT, saying it was wrong and would savage Bahamians. Marco City MP Greg Moss continued his rampage against his own party after he suggested during a House of Assembly intervention that he does not fear Prime Minister Perry Christie in the face of perceived political threats. He went on to tell parliamentarians that he would not be deterred by those perceived threats of consequences from the nation's chief over a different position than that of the Progressive Liberal Party. The comments sparked a back-and-forth argument between Moss, Foxhill MP Fred Mitchell, and Cat Island, Rumkey, and San Salvador MP Philip Brave Davis, who defended Mr. Christie because he was not in the House when Mr. Moss made the comments. However, Mr. Christie returned to the House a short time later to rebut what Mr. Moss had to say. Mr. Christie questioned the defensive nature of Mr. Moss's comments, saying that they met each other moments before the session in an amicable meeting. Later, Mr. Christie made another intervention about the dissenting views of his party's backbenchers. This time it was stern. He warned that such views would lead to repercussions.
In a pointed and, to say the least, scathing communication in the House of Assembly, PLP MP for Fort Charlotte, Dr. Andre Rollins, stunned many when he called for new leadership within his own party. However, those remarks landed Dr. Rollins in a bit of hot water.
It was quite the stunning scene in the House of Assembly on Wednesday, as Fort Charlotte MP Dr. Andre Rollins said that after listening to Prime Minister Perry Christie's comments on value-added tax, it was clear that the nation needed new leadership. Lashing out at his own party, Dr. Rollins accused the Prime Minister of threatening him for not towing the party line and, quote, wasting the public's time, end quote, by quoting scriptures instead of focusing on the critical debate. And because Prime Minister Perry Christie was absent from those meetings at the time of Mr. Rollins' remarks, as he was attending business outside of the country, Acting Prime Minister Philip Brave Davis called on Mr. Rollins at the time to do the honorable thing. Mr. Davis said Dr. Rollins was out of line for the comments and he said that he was willing to meet with the Fort Charlotte MP to discuss how he could go about doing the right thing. He said, quote, "It pains me to know that the member for Fort Charlotte crossed the line today. When I say cross the line, I mean the fact that he is on that side does not make him any different from us on this side. Perhaps because he is sitting there, it has influenced him to think that he is in opposition. He crossed the line. He called the Prime Minister's leadership into question, and it was not right to do that. And I will defend his right. I defend his right, and Dr. Rollins crossed the line when he called into question the leader and his motives, and in fact suggesting that he should no longer be leader. I will say no more," end quote. However, it seems that through Dr. Rollins' show of independence from his party, interest has been sparked, not only from the Free National Movement, but within the Democratic National Alliance. Both parties said they would welcome the embattled MP. Days before, Dr. Rollins stepped down as party whip because his views were different from that of the parties on the gender equality bill. Dr. Rollins was later axed as gaming board chairman on Friday afternoon. Sources within the party confirmed to the Tribune that the DPM terminated the Fort Charlotte MP through a letter which was hand-delivered to Dr. Rollins.
Want to get in on the discussion? Well, here's how you can. Just log on to our website at www.tribune242.com, like us on Facebook at the Tribune News Network, or send us a tweet at Tribune242.